Welcome to Mr. Mitsubishi. YouTube channel covers a lot of all new Outlander, all new PHEV stuff. Today in this video, we'll have a look at this. The Outlander PHEV has these paddle shifters by the steering wheel. It's something to do with regenerative braking. And in this video, we'll do a real life test how it works downhill in a downhill situation. We'll talk about the functionality of it and we'll see in real life what some of the benefits might be to use those versus not using them. So right now, let's check out that video and let's head to our testing facility, which is Burnaby Mountain here in BC. So let's talk about these paddle shifters here. So one is plus, the other is minus, and this is to manage your regenerative braking force. It has these five settings or six settings. It goes from B0 to B5. So B5 is the strongest force that you'll get. And the feeling that you get is once you start paddle shifting, as if the vehicle would brake for you without you applying the brake pedal. It always defaults to B2. So when you release your gas pedal and whatnot, it just feels like you're rolling, but there's a little bit of resistance. On the B6, on the B5, it feels quite strong. And the energy is, the idea is quite simple. So you capture that energy that you're using from braking and you charge the battery with it. Now, the good news is the braking does not happen with your brake pads and rotors. It happens with the electric motors. It's very easy then on brakes, and it's good for long-term maintenance on your brakes. You're just wearing out your brakes and pads less in that time. So what we'll be doing today, so we're going to head up to Burnaby Mountain and we're going to drive down. It's about 3 kilometer drive down, but it's quite steep, and we'll test it how many kilometers we can regenerate back on that drive down. So we'll start with certain kilometers. We're going to use this regenerative braking. We're not going to be using anything else, and we'll see how many kilometers we capture back. I've used this option, this plus and minus shifting, quite a bit on the previous Outlander. It works like magic, especially in your like longer drives, road trips, summer trips. If you go up and down the hill, once you're in that downhill situation, so instead of pressing the regular brake pedal, you just use plus and minus and you slow the car down, or like you kind of let go of it a little bit. You basically just regulate your speed with plus and minus, and you just keep capturing that energy and pushing all the back in a battery so you can use it for your EV mode. So right now, let's head over there, let's test it out and see how it works. In a city, you have two choices. Either you use this plus and minus to slow down. So right now we can put it on B1 and we're rolling, and then we go to like B5 and we're basically stopping almost. Just remember, the car keeps on rolling. You still have to press the brake pedal, but we can use these paddle shifters to play with this B0 to B5 setting to slow down if we hit the red light. But I used that a lot on the previous Outlander PHEV, but on this one here, we have this innovative pedal feature. So once we click this, so this is more so for the city driving, and this innovative pedal right now combines the gas pedal with the brake pedal in a way. So the second you release, you take your foot off of the gas pedal, the vehicle automatically slows down. It has this regenerative braking force built into that pedal. You can't have selections how strong the pedal is going to be. It's only like one selection. It's quite strong. So to me, for the city drive, it's the best to use the innovative pedal. But these paddle shifters, they're more so for a highway drive, down the hill situation and whatnot. Everybody might have a little bit different preferences. When you start to drive your Outlander, you might think that, okay, it's a little bit better to play around with these like paddle shifters instead of using the innovative pedal. Up to you, obviously. But for me, I find city works innovative pedal the best. And this is more so for a highway drive, down the hill situations where I can capture it and just play around with that. So right now, let's keep on heading to our testing facility. So we are at the Burnaby Mountain Park, and right now we're as high as it gets here, and we're going to be driving down. Like I said, it's about 3 kilometers or so. going downhill, so we'll have a plenty of time to test how it goes, how many kilometers it'll charge, and we'll demonstrate the plus and minus paddle shifter benefits in real life situation. Let's go. And here we go. So right now, let's play around with this. So we're at B0, so, and we can go to B1. We're starting at 10 kilometers. So we'll see if we'll be able to capture some of that energy. And then as we go down, I'm gonna just apply a little bit more pressure, or let go, like right now B1, because I need to get up to speed. Then go with minus to increase the B resistance. So the speed limit is 60 kilometers here, so we'll go with that. And this is the cool part about this plus and minus. So you can literally feel, okay, I need to slow down a bit, then you go a little bit higher, B4, and then if you slow down too much, then okay, now you can let go and go to B2. And we can see in this chart as well how the captured energy changes. And here's one thing that I get asked, if brake lights come on when you're doing this regenerative braking, and the answer is yes. And you can see that on the flow chart right here. If I do a little bit more braking, see the brake light came on right here. So you're safe there. And as we drive down the hill, I really like to play with this plus and minus, and you can see your kilometers go, an hour go up and down. And just saw, if we go to B0, this is a neutral position, nothing is happening. So B0 won't capture anything. And we see we already at 13 kilometer range. So in short drive like this, we increased, or we generated back 3 kilometers. Okay, I'm going too fast. There we go. A little bit more force to B4. Now we'll go back. Plus it makes you feel like you're a Formula One driver or something. It's pretty cool to use those paddle shifters once in a while. There we go. And as we're approaching to set of lights, we can loosen up here and just go to B2, okay. And now we're gonna go B4, B5 to slow down and almost stop and see how the light comes on, so the car behind us knows that we're stopping. And we're at 15 kilometers. So that's it, our little test drive is done. So in about a 3 kilometer downhill, fairly steep, we recouped 5 kilometers. So we generated 5 kilometers just by using this plus and minus pedals. Depending where you live, you might even have like such drives on, on your daily drive, where you go pretty steep down the hill. And those are situations where you want to use this these paddle shifters, because on my daily driving, sometimes even on a short drive, very, very short, you go down the steep hill and you can pick up extra 1 or 2 kilometers. So obviously, like, it's not a huge deal to pick up 1 or 2 kilometers, but I find once you own an electric car or plug-in hybrid, your entire driving is kind of gearing towards just squeezing those kilometers, finding where you can save extra kilometers. And your kind of like, driving style and habits change a little bit. And then once you drive it, then you're like, okay, 2 kilometers is a big deal. I want to capture that. Or in this case, just by using the pedals, we were able to generate 5 kilometers. So we started with 10, we finished with 15, and that's just in a short 3 kilometer downhill. So there we go. I hope this video helped you to put a practical understanding of how these plus and minus shifters work, because these questions I still get asked a lot. What exactly do they do? How do they differ from this innovative pedal, and how you can use them on a daily basis like that? So by the way, this does not work together with the innovative pedal, so it's one or the other. The downforce, or like the braking force that you will use on or feel on innovative pedal, is going to be a lot stronger. So but this plus and minus, sometimes I like to even just use that for fun, because like I said, you just you know, feel like shifting something, and you know, you're more engaged into driving. So there we go. Thanks again for checking out this video. If you haven't subscribed to the channel, please do so. We'll be doing a lot more different kind of PHEV tests. And on to the next one.